expanding their ever-increasing hold on the important Jap island chain of the Ryukyus, the Marines make two more landings which help protect our bases on Okinawa. These latest attacks were made on Iheya, 25 miles northwest of Okinawa, and at Aguni, 35 miles west. As our forces drive closer to the main Jap islands, more and more enemy troops learn to surrender to our humane Yanks. Many of them are still frightened because of the false propaganda issued by the Jap warlords, telling of the cruel treatment handed out by Americans. But these handouts of cigarettes and other gifts tell a different story. The battle for these two new valuable outposts is over. Victory here is complete. Meanwhile, on Okinawa, the last diehard Japs are being routed from their hold. These nips believed the propaganda and suffered the consequences as shown by official Marine Corps pictures. Shell-shocked, a native child is taken in by the Marine. Prisoner of war stockades receive thousands of enemy captives rounded up as the advance continues. With Okinawa and others of the Ryukyu safe in Yank hands, the sea and air war is being carried to the very shores of Tokyo itself. As the bag of prisoners grows, the bases we have taken from them are being turned to the steadily increasing destruction of enemy war industry. General Joseph Stilwell is on hand to witness final victory. Here is where the Jap's commanding general died, and with him died the hopes of the enemy on Okinawa.